Bagley again, and proceeding to con him out of a lot of money and some robot parts. You guys made your way to a much less abandoned Empire psionics research facility, and for a while did a pretty good job at stealthily infiltrating it before things naturally devolved into chaos. And it's in that chaos you guys are gonna find yourselves as the two robotic members of the party are in desperate need of repairs, and the party as a whole is standing over what seems to be someone maybe related to Mirica.
So Mirica, when were you gonna tell us about your twin?
So, Mirica, you're looking at this person, and it definitely looks like someone who would be from, like, the planet you're from. But you aren't really familiar with them. Like, the face itself isn't particularly, familiar.
Are we in another fight already?
It's just a general vibe of... The alarm is still going while this, the station is still in high alert.
I have a thing for that once you're done explaining to Mirica.
Yeah, well, I mean, that's pretty much all I need to explain. Mirica, this is definitely someone sort of from your planet and village, but it's not someone you recognize.
That alarm's getting annoying. Is there like a control panel or something? I'm asking in character while I'm actually looking around, like a sort of control panel or so, or like a thing where you would activate the alarm.
Well, we can go on a murder spree for the rest of these guys.
Well, I want to do something about that alarm.
As Fist says this, like he's like sparking and leaking oil.
Is there any control?
I'd like to remind. Yes. I don't know if health has been like reset in any way.
No.
But I'd like to. Yeah, I'd like to remind the robot members that you are both one HP above being unconscious.
Well, I'm asking, is there a control panel around? Damn it.
You can look for one with a.
Wait, in this.
I'd say wit investigation. I'll also allow space-wise, since you're kind of like trying to suss out like a weird ship.
Fizz, can you help me with that one?
I'll give him my best shot. Wit space-wise.
Because I don't have wit or good space-wise.
Two plus one for the map.
Oh shit! Really?
That's all the way.
All right, let's see.
Get out of the way.
What is it, wit, space, wit?
That was wit, space wise.
Wit investigation, ding.
I mean, I wouldn't bother on a Joker.
What? Do I not get a chance to? God damn it!
It's fine though. I
had an idea for something.
So you guys don't spend much time pondering. What appears to be the Mirica-like human. And immediately go off to kind of look for a sort of security panel. And sort of as you're searching, you can't really find it, but you do end up in... you do end up sort of like in a holding cell, and you see like kind of like... The holding cell that you're in is like still active. Or, like, the room with the holding cell, rather. And you do see kind of a small figure inside of it. Just sort of, like, facing away.
What? I had an idea for something. Fuck.
No way, could that be?
Wait, is that Scraggly?
Here he...
No. It can't be.
Hearing the sounds of people like come into the room, Scraggly kind of whips around and goes, "You'll never take me alive, Empire."
How'd you even...
Oh, hey, you fellas look familiar.
God damn it, Scraggly. Can I do a wit invest for a control panel? I'm looking for something, please.
Sure. Give it.
Oh, one success.
Fuck it. There's a control panel on the wall in here.
All right, can I hack it?
Sure. Give me intelligence computers.
Okay, that's 5.
Hey, fella, while you're at it, could you let me out of here?
No. Oh, God. Not the joke. God damn it! I had an idea for something, but...
I'll do a great start.
Please. Please, Ding, I had a great idea for something.
Okay, you did get 2 successes. What did you want to do?
I wanted to hack the control panel and play a song over the entire space station.
Okay, you can do that, but then you're going to have a joker.
Okay. So, thank you. I'm sorry. I had this plan all week. I was prepping for this. So, this... Not that! Why was that saved? Not that.
You have to clear the queue anyway before.
Yeah. Sorry. I'm sorry. That is not what I meant. I was not trying to do a funny. I thought I had the other thing saved that I was just looking at. But apparently all I did was open the tab and like just close the video without even saving the girl. This starts playing. Over the entire station.
All right. This
hopefully that kind of throws off the whatever.
This song starts playing over the over sort of the loudspeakers that would you manage to hack into the loudspeakers that would normally be for like announcements and like calling out like where you guys are and play this song. However, in the process, you kind of suffer an electric shock that deals you 1 damage.
Oh god! I'm unconscious again.
I know you are.
I guess Fist is gonna do his best to. Well, he's human size right now, isn't he?
He is.
Yeah.
So it's not gonna be. It won't be hard for 2 4 brawn characters to carry him around at least.
Yeah.
Until you guys find some way to repair the robot members of the party.
At least I got this going.
Well,
and my final message.
Speaking of that, Scraggly, would you have anything to help repair me and my friend here? In exchange, we might find a way to get you out of here.
Sure. You know, some folks who look a lot like you actually just sold me a lot of primo robot parts recently.
Is that so? We're looking for more traditional parts, however.
Well, I could easily show you my full selection if you let me out of here.
I take it's not going to be as easy as... some guard left a key around.
No, not quite. Although being on the outside of it, you do see there is a keypad.
Okay. Well,
believe it or not, most Empire jail cells are actually designed to be much easier to open from the outside than the inside.
That's fair. So is it simple controls on the keypad, or is it locked down type of thing?
It's definitely looking like the keypad is in kind of like a high security state.
Yeah.
Without proper clearance, it's like not gonna let you put in a code.
Yes, I'll try hacking it.
All right, that will be intelligence and computers.
3, 4. Definitely not healthy. Wow.
Come on.
Okay. Yo, you can make some ballsy rolls from that one, though.
That is true. That is true. Fist burned both of his jokers already.
Yep. And then no successes.
So, I'm going to say, with no successes in a joker, you completely fail to realize that it's in any sort of lockdown state and just sort of start trying to put in random codes.
Zero, 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 zero.
And suddenly, and sort of the second you try and put in the first code without putting in, without trying to, like, show it your key card, you just hear this, like, loud siren just blare from it. And as that happens, you're starting to hear the loud sort of banging of booted footsteps approaching.
Well,
can I really not heal anyone without these any robots without a repair kit?
Without any parts, it's gonna be pretty, pretty tough.
All
right. So I got one thing out before I went unconscious.
Yes.
I left my legacy.
But you guys aren't in combat yet. The people are fast approaching.
Well, people are already on their way.
Yeah.
Would it be easy enough to just... Would smashing the keypad work?
Yeah, with a brawn melee, you could potentially just, like, blast it.
Well, you know, if you can't do it the easy way, the easier way has your back.
You easily just send a hole, like, right through the wall where the keypad is. And with a...
disable it, but Scraggly can crawl through.
No, I'm going to say for three successes and with guards already on their way.
Yeah.
A loud bang, the security, the force field, the force field, like, immediately just kind of, like, destabilizes and deactivates.
Sweet. All right. Hey, we might need your help with some other things as well here.
That's a Scraggly?
That's the Scraggly.
Ah, well, sure thing, fellas. But anyway, he produces a pretty shitty looking, but on closer inspection, completely competent repair kit.
Sweet.
Ooh, nice.
We can work out the payment after this is all over.
For sure, I got you, Scraggly.
Sounds good.
All right. So Zedge, I'm assuming you're trying to repair both people. I'm trying to figure out. It probably won't take that long to make you just. You could. That is true. You could choose to not repair one of them.
I mean, I was thinking repairing both would be like, I need a very good roll to get anything.
Well, no. Well, I meant more like. I was trying to think of how to do it, like, in a way other than, like, having you flip twice.
Oh, I can flip twice.
Okay. I was thinking that, but then the second I said that, I'm like, actually, flipping twice isn't really, like, it isn't that long.
Yeah.
So it's intelligence engineering for each time you want to repair.
And it has three uses.
Yes.
I wish I could hear what the guard's reaction to the current PA system knows.
And because you guys are still technically out of combat, I'm going to give this action lethal one.
Sweet.
Well, and my second set.
Should we anti-joker that?
Okay, the second one went really well. So is,
all right.
Is that just...
Well, first thing,
is this
first
an overall role?
I'm going to say... I'm going to say, let me know who gets who. Because you didn't decide before flipping, now I want you to choose who's getting which flip.
Okay, Star Blitz is like 2 HP, already unconscious, so I give my good one to that.
Moon Blitz, not Star Blitz, Edge.
I don't know why I said that. Anyway.
The moon is a star if you think about it.
But it really is.
You have to think very hard.
It's big brain energy.
Listen, in Animal Crossing, you make them. Listen, guys, in Animal Crossing, you make the moon using star fragments.
Okay, that's fine.
Obviously a star.
And then who's got the answer, Joker? If you're the answer, Joker.
Or is it me?
I believe that was.
It was me.
Yeah. Oh, it was? Okay, then I didn't erase mine from last time.
Yep. I think this is probably a safe bet for it, unless you want to save it for...
We have to... We get fucking shitty jokers.
Every joker's a shitty joker.
There's no such thing as a non-shitty joker.
Well, no. There's only Steve Bragley. That's not really that shitty of a...
That is true. Finding old Scraggly is actually.
If no one has objections, I'll just use it.
All right.
Sin gets my crit.
Okay, so that's Hold on. There's like crits and lethal going through. So that
is
makes
the solo or the.
Hmm?
Oh no, the ace was the solo, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was.
Yeah.
So Moon Blitz is getting +5 to help, +5. So that's a full heal for you. And then it's just +2 for Fist.
Yeah.
Moon Blitz sits up meaty, is like, I saw him. The legend. Saw Tom Jones in the afterlife.
I saw Space Tom Jones.
Well, that's nice and all, but guards are on the way. So be ready.
Are we skedaddling out of here, or are we dealing with that? And Moonblitz is going to point towards the similar-looking Mirica.
Oh, you guys are away. You guys are far away from that at this point.
Oh.
So I'm going to say... It's either stay and fight or give me agility athletics to run.
I'm fine with fighting.
You are?
I mean, depends how many there are.
I mean, I thought my distraction would help throw them off. I'm not sure.
Okay then, agility.
I mean, it would if there wasn't like a keypad that got like a solid couple minutes of like ear piercing sirens off. That kind of casts a pretty clear picture of where the intruders are, Tom Jones or not.
Can I fly down the hall? Is there enough room?
There's enough room if you're willing to take like a -2 to the flip.
Yeah, sure.
All right. So is everyone running or is Moonblitz running?
Oh, I was.
I just flipped. I only have one card.
Are we running?
I guess we're trying. Yeah, that's
That's usually 7. Do I still get a bonus if I'm healthy though?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's 6. Wow.
Very cool.
That was so bad. I'm gonna use. What?
Chibu didn't either. I don't know if they're.
We're all kind of fuddled right now.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah, I'm gonna say. 2 successes amongst the group is probably not enough.
Yeah.
So you guys like try to sort of scramble out. It's a little tough. Mirika's still not super used to running in a cat body. And Moonblitz, you find it far harder to navigate in this fairly tight corridor in your ship form than you thought you would.
Even with my new size, yeah. With my new size changing ability. I assume, right?
Yeah. So, pretty soon you guys, like, after a while, you guys sort of, like, realize, like, the chase is not going up. And you turn to face what looks to be 5 Empire troopers. When suddenly, a sort of like, kind of like what almost seems to be like a red beam, just kind of just sort of like goes flying through the roof and into the troopers, sort of like slicing them and knocking them back. In a very, very, in a very, very anime fashion. A surprisingly tall, you guys are now realizing, human woman comes through the hole that it was made in the ceiling by it.
Oh, Lord.
As the commander turns to you and goes, I'm starting to realize that subterfuge is not really your guys' strong suit.
Don't worry about it.
Can't say I'm not happy about it though. Whatever you did to fuck up the security around here also fucked up whatever they were doing to cloak it. This is a pretty big opportunity for us.
What's the plan?
Well, my plan is killing as many of these Empire bastards as I can and taking the credit for your guys' hard work. The plan for you guys is getting to the bottom of whatever you need to get Mirika out of that body.
Sounds like a fair trade.
And sort of, no sooner does she say that than just she's kind of like rushes towards what seems to be some more heavily armored Empire troops.
While Tom Jones is playing.
I know, it's not a very fitting theme track for it, but this is the reality I have.
But goddamn if it's not a good song, though. If you ever want to change it back to the normal music, you can go ahead, ding.
No, we're gonna keep this for a while.
That's good. This is what I was planning all week. I was so excited to hopefully have it work.
Not quite.
It took you like 3 jokers to get here. We'll keep it on for a while.
God damn it, this is my blood, sweat, and tears. I'm sticking to my idea. Oh, what happened? Groovy just cut out.
Not for me.
On my end too.
So
also out of character, that's right, we're here for Mirika. We can't exactly run out of here. Keep forgetting.
Yeah. I mean, we can run away from the encounter, but
yeah, I think that's what we've been doing.
Yeah. I didn't mean like you guys weren't escaping from the ship at all. I just meant like it was either like stand your ground in that room and fight in that room or try and avoid the encounter by running. So you guys now have to navigate around this ship. Although you do notice there's sort of like you guys kind of like wander around for a while and it's just as bafflingly designed on the inside as it is on the outside. But eventually you do seem at the end of sort of like a T intersection, what appears to be kind of a, what appears to be a bit of a, like some sort of like map for the crew if they're having a hard time navigating.
I'm gonna save a screenshot of it.
Like big mall kiosk.
Yeah, pretty much.
You are here.
But it's pretty far away, and still, and standing near it is like one like very heavily sort of armed and armored Empire trooper and another Scion.
You think these guys will tell us where the gift shop is?
You got any more distractions up your sleeve?
Music is sort of the only is sort of my only bag.
Yeah, I'm gonna go out on a limb and say that and say that Moonblitz playing music from himself is probably not going to do a very good job of making these two not notice you.
Probably not.
although they are kind of tapping their feet to the music that's playing over the intercom already.
Yes.
Well, the one guard is. The Scion is staying kind of stoic.
That guard has good taste, though.
So what do we want to do, guys?
Well, I mean, I think we have to get through them to even get to the map, right?
I got a grenade, and so if we want to do some blasting.
Unless Scraggly has some binoculars.
Hmm.
Oh, that's right, Scraggly's here.
I might have something like that.
Does he still have his bag? It didn't get confiscated?
He somehow still has his bag. But only one free item a day is the Scraggly special, after all.
We paid you, it's letting you out.
Nope.
Fair enough.
Alright.
He kind of rummages around in his bag. And he's got a pair of binoculars, sort of. They're more of a telescope at this point. With seeing as how one of the lenses is completely missing from one side.
Yeah, well, as long as it partially works.
What do you think about 100 spucks for it?
How much do we have?
We have 2190.
Do we bring those with us? Or are those on the ship?
Let's say they're with
us. I'm going to go on a limb and say they're with you guys. But for future reference, I want one of you to decide who actually has it on them.
Okay.
I don't know. That could be any of you guys. But
I'm the one keeping track of it. So.
Okay. So let's say... So Fist, add Spucks to your non-useful items, just so we know that you are the one who has all the money.
All right.
So, if you guys are buying them, I'm gonna say that you. You do a pretty good job. You sort of trade the money over, and Fist, to your useful items, you can add mostly broken binoculars that will give +1 to investigation actions.
The uninocular.
The uninocular.
+1.
All right. And then at the same time, if you're gonna use them, then it's a wit and investigation plus one to read the kiosk from here.
I can give it a shot unless someone else wants to. I've got two investigation.
It's more than me.
I also have two investigation.
Two investigation and one wit.
I have one wit.
Yeah, I guess it's best we get. So one.
Jibu is saying he can do it.
He can do it? Okay.
I believe Mirka has a one more flip than anyone else here. Just with four wit.
I'll toss the new uninocular her way then.
All right, Mirka, add that to your useful items and give me a wit investigation plus one.
Yeah, it's far better than that.
She's reading the shit out of it.
Write that down.
The part of the uninocular that does work works well enough for you to kind of like read it from here and sort of take note of what seems to be a section that is conspicuously like almost like someone went in Photoshop and just like erased it off of the map very hastily. And you assume any
like that's important.
You assume any especially crazy tech is probably going to be there. Unfortunately, you have to take a left directly from where you are, which means you're going to need to like sneak or otherwise get by the guards still.
All right, I'm going to try sneaking first. What's the attribute to go with
the panel off the wall?
There are indeed many panels here, Fist.
There are it's the same types of walls as the rest of the ship.
What's the first attribute with
just a normal kind of sneak by, it's agility sneaking.
Oh, good.
Alright, Fist, if he fucks up, get that fucking panel.
So, wait, what's that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh, shit.
Like, we won't be nice. Or he won't be.
And I critted on that. That was such a good flip. Damn it. That was a waste. Never mind. I'm not going to say it's a waste, but out of all the things to flip really good on, I'm surprised it's sneak. I'm just going to say
for four successes, I'm going to say you
five,
can take one.
For
five successes, I'm going to say you can take two people with you.
All right. Who's got the shittiest sneak?
I have no sneaking, but I have decent agility.
I have no sneaking and no agility.
I'll take you and... Should we leave Scraggly on? Should I help Scraggly, or do you need help, Mirka? Do you want to try on your own then, Jibu? / Mirka? I don't know if I'm talking in character or out of character.
Both simultaneously.
Don't say that.
Oh god.
I guess because he's a wild card, I'm gonna take Scraggly with me as well. So Scraggly and Fist. Pika and Scraggly.
Yeah.
Okay. So you take Pika and Scraggly. They're small enough for sort of like even in this form to kind of like just carry sort of underarm. And you just sort of like Scooby-Doo tiptoe to the corner while they're looking
even
away.
Even hear like the piano ting.
Absolutely. No, 100. That's entirely what I had in mind. A little. And you get far enough out of range for his bulky helmet and the Scion. Literally, like, not allowing for vision helmet to see you. But that does leave the other two party members.
Alright. That looks easy enough. It's just agility sneaking.
Yeah, I wasn't going to trust Scraggly. No offense to Scraggly, but...
I was once.
I mean, if you combine it, it's two, which is technically a success.
You guys, listen, I'm not saying you guys have to use any hero points or drive. What I am saying is you're trying to sneak by someone who is basically psychically scanning their surroundings instead of actually like seeing.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's never mind.
Eesh. It'd really be like that.
Why today?
Mirka and Fist, you guys attempt to sneak by, and then kind of halfway through sneaking, Mirka, you start to do that thing that cats do before they puke. And as anyone who owns a cat knows,
yes,
there is no not noticing that.
Yeah.
So the guards immediately see you, and the one calls out, "The intruders!"
Fist. Punnels.
Tom Waits fades out as... No, not Tom Waits.
Tom Jones. You fucking plebeian.
Tom Jones fades out as Mirka and Fist enter combat.
All right.
Oh my fucking god. Groceries.
So yeah, so this is gonna be the sort of the heavily armored trooper. And the red one is the Scion. Yeah. And of course, as always, the Scion kind of puts up the thin energy shield that you guys sort of have to push your way through to attack.
Like, really weirdly, like, stuttery for anyone else?
It is stuttering a little bit for me.
Okay, so it's not just me.
It's really bad for me.
Yeah,
it's bad for me.
Leave.
Rest in peace, Groovy.
Its server might just be like overloaded right now.
Yeah,
probably.
All right. I'm gonna check these guys' initiative, but it's definitely not five. So go ahead and, or actually, Space. If you you will have to join combat if you want to participate.
Ooh, it's back to normal now.
Oh my god, my command worked!
Unfuck. It's just that simple.
It's so easy.
Or actually, you know what? Mirka and you guys have initiative ties with both of these guys. So both of you flip one card, Mirka and Fist. All right, Mirka and Fist, you guys go first. We're gonna do a round with just you guys and the two.
Okay.
Since initiative started with just the four of you, the first round is gonna be just the four of you.
Well,
so Fist, you're up.
We can join the combat if things get hairy, right?
I guess we'll try going for that panel.
After these four have all taken a turn, you guys can jump in when it's realistically your initiative order.
Is that the second time that Merica or Jibu said I got it and then immediately jokered?
I think so.
But not the last.
I feel like you should stop saying I got it, because that kind of jinxes it.
Jibu just wanted to fight. He did that on purpose. Alright, so Fist, it's gonna be your turn.
He's gonna go for the nearest panel and kind of hold it up in a more defensive fashion.
Okay, give me, I'd say that's Brawn Athletics to pull a panel out of the wall. For two successes, yeah. You kind of pull a panel out and kind of use it to sort of shield the more damaged parts of your body. You can say everyone here is gonna have to flip one less card against you.
I'm like silently cheering like behind my box, just in view of Fist.
And just in time for the Scion. Gonna make a move on. Gonna make a move on Mirica and get two successes. So that's take two dodge off Mirica as you kind of have to sort of jump out of the way of kind of like a wave of telekinetic force. It's now your turn, Mirica. Oh. All right, I'm gonna say that's presence telepathy minus one, since the Scion kind of has some shielding against that. Ooh, all right.
Nice roll.
He got this.
For that, like, the Scion kind of, like, staggers and kind of loses its balance for a moment. But it sort of ends up like righting itself somewhat after a while, but it is kind of swaying back and forth. Full transparency, I took one success off of that because I forgot that her ally there. Actually, because he's sort of like a defender guard, he gives his other allies, like, he gives people other than him plus one interference. So technically you were supposed to be minus two there. And he's now going to try and take a shot at, the sort of defending himself Fist. He readies a shot, and his gun kind of powers up for a second, but then sort of unpowers immediately. And he's just kind of like looking at it and just smacking it and trying to figure out what's going on as laser gun has seemed to jam somehow. All right. And now that they've taken their turn, Moonblitz, you can join combat now.
Okay.
He said back, but I'm not sure who's actually back.
Supposedly.
Oh fuck, I was muted. Fuck me. Sorry.
Yeah, you can join combat now if you want. Started combat has taken a turn.
Has anyone been downed yet? Or
no, but the yet? But the Scion took like the Scion took a pretty bad hit and is just kind of like wavering back and forth.
And Blizz is gonna take a shot at the Scion with his crossbow.
So this is going to be agility and firearms minus 2.
So that's...
Okay.
6. So healthy. So 4. Oh.
The defender troop kind of like holds his arm out, and from sort of the palm of his hand, like kind of like an energy shield appears and kind of deflects the bullet.
Kind of, damn.
You're gonna have to do better than that, bot. And I'm gonna say it's. So, okay, hold on. Let's.
I mean,
so, seeing the fight break out, Scraggly kind of like takes his bag off of his back and just sort of throws it, and then just jumps down and kind of like smacks it a couple times. And just this, like, sort of, like, not much taller than him, and kind of, like, rusted over-looking, just, like, sort of humanoid security drone, just cobbled out of various robot parts, just kind of rises up from the bag. And Scraggly just kind of, like, don't worry, me and Scraggly 2 got this!
I don't know if we do, actually.
Scraggly 2.
Wait, is Scraggly human?
No, he's a Puppalonian.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
And, Fist, it's your turn again.
Alright. I guess with panel in hand, I'm just gonna rush and try to, like, crush him against the kiosk there. Probably the Scion, since they're still.
Okay, so you're going for the Scion with the panel?
Yeah.
Alright, Brawn Melee. Well, you guys are definitely going to be relying on Mirica's memory drawn out as the Scion goes flying into the kiosk and just sort of like smashes into it, just like breaking in sort of a sea of sparks that she then just kind of slumps down against the wall from.
That's what I'm talking about.
Ah, shit! Shit! The defender is looking pretty scared, but is sort of like puts his shield up and is kind of still holding his ground. As it becomes Mirica's turn. And we can get this one out of here. It's done for.
Sick.
All right. I'm gonna say, in the interest of like making Mirica a bit stronger in combat scenarios, I'm gonna say that for telekinesis actions that are just sort of like moving objects, I'm going to say those are going to be wit and telekinesis. So give me that flip. Oh, plus one, of course, because of your pendant. Okay. Yeah, you take the energy shield away from the defender, who is now gonna be, you guys are gonna get, an extra flip on him as he kind of, like, loses balance and is now without a shield.
Sweet.
Nice.
And, with that, is, Pikachu, do you wanna join the bat? Do you wanna join the melee?
Sure do.
Alright.
So... is the energy shield something I can, like, touch? Like, what's it made out of?
It's kind of just like, it's more or less just sort of like...
is it just, like, solid? Pretty much?
Deactivated, it's kind of like a sphere. And then sort of a rectangular well, not a sphere, it's like a circle. That you kind of hold a handle on the back on. And sort of, when you activate it, kind of like a rectangular shield kind of comes out from the circle.
Like the floorlight in Animal Crossing, but it produces a shield.
Yeah, pretty okay. much.
anyway, I'm just gonna do an energy blossom.
Alright, give me a brawn firearms plus two. That is one from your gun, one from your, one from him, not being very, not in a very... despite being a defender, not being very defensive right now.
Dumb. I'll
take you take full advantage of the opening and just get a and just sort of get a blast kind of right between like a crack between like his shoulder armor and his helmet that sort of takes his helmet right off and just sort of leaves his head in kind of like a Looney Tunes-esque char.
Is he still alive?
As he also falls to the ground.
Okay.
Dead or otherwise incapacitated.
Hey, that was great timing with the music.
Yeah, I know.
Just will gently place down the panel on top of, or right next, like leaning onto the broken kiosk.
Okay.
Now, what we need in this total, we inevitably run into more trouble later.
Alright.
That's a good question.
Hmm?
She just asked about it.
Yeah, if someone wants to pick it up, go for it.
What's happening?
There's free energy sort of shield. Like a, there's an energy shield on the ground that the defender was using.
Does anyone need it? I feel like I get knocked out a lot.
You get knocked out a lot.
Either you or Mirica have the lowest health.
Yeah.
Mirica can create shields, though, with a telekinesis cannon.
And you have less dodge.
Yeah.
Alright.
So do I get the shield?
Yeah, you can add... you can add plus one... add one, add like an energy shield to your useful items.
Mm-hmm.
It gives plus one interference, but this model isn't like super fortified, and if an enemy crits it, it'll short out.
Okay. What does interference mean exactly?
Basically, people are gonna flip one less card attacking you.
Okay. Well, that's pretty handy.
Yeah.
For flavor, could I say that I could attach it to my arm? Because, you know, it's mechanical.
Yeah, sure. You affix it to the arm opposite the laser shield. The laser sword.
Nice.
Snazzy.
All right, Mirka. So, as the one kind of as the one who sort of knows the way around, give me intelligence and space-wise to lead the party. Assuming you want to lead them to the scribbled off area of the lab. Yeah, two successes will do it. You guys kind of go for a while until you find more towards like the bottom of the station. Like a very heavy looking door. Like a very sort of like a fortified airlock of sorts. And this one appears to be activated by a fingerprint scanner on the side.
I have a weird idea. Okay. Actually, I don't know if that'll work. Well, these scions, did the last scion we fought also look like Mirka?
You guys didn't examine that one. That one, but it's very possible.
I'm not saying she should, but what happens if Mirka puts her hand on the fingerprint scanner? Anybody?
Do you want to try?
I don't know. It's up to America. Oh god.
Let's go.
Mirka, as you put your Ketonian paw up to the scanner.
Oh yeah. Right.
It sort of buzzes and goes, unauthorized fingerprint detected.
Hey, first, you mind working your magic here?
What kind of hole we trying to make here?
I'm thinking a moderate hole.
Moderate hole.
Well, I mean, try to make a big enough hole. I gotta fit through with these wings, man.
Well.
Okay, so making a hole in the door or the wall with the scanner.
Can I try and hack it?
I mean,
it?
I was going for the scanner, but either it seems fine.
I've been feeling well, mostly useless this whole round.
I will say, one will be very hard to do. One will have unintended consequences.
Unforeseen consequences.
How far away are the people we knocked out?
They're enough a ways away for me to work in a wrench in the plant to make it not so easy as running back and get them.
Who has America's body?
Oh, that's right, I'm carrying it. I put up the unconscious America hand that's actually America to the scanner. I totally forgot I had that. I was carrying around something really important. So this is actually America's hand now.
You place the actual America hand to the scanner, and it kind of like formulates for a moment and just sort of goes like, unregistered scion detected. Would you like to take a moment to register this scion?
Sure. Do we have a dummy email account we can use? So we go through the registering process.
Yep. A cool thing is, according to Empire laws, you technically own America now, Moonblitz, which is cool.
That is... not my intended. That's not my intention at all. Moonblitz turns to Mirka and goes, no. Don't ever think that. Please. God, that's awful.
It'll be a Django style relationship.
What?
Mirica unchained. So after that whole, after that's kind of resolved.
Empire are just the fucking worst. Moonblitz, like, kind of utters as he's having to go through the terms of service.
You have to sign yes on the, you have to sign that you agree to the space UCLA. Or what, not the UCLA. The, what's the fucking terms of service for Steam games?
Oh. EULCA? Or EULA?
EULA, and use your license agreement.
Yeah. Don't worry, I don't think anyone actually reads these things.
And...
Oh, looks like we get a free coupon for...
No, I am not Empire signing Dennis. Up for newsletter. Uncheck that right now, Fist.
Check it.
Don't. Wait, fuck you, I'm doing this.
I mean, it's a free 20% off for Neo New Earth Denny's here.
Both of you flip one card. Fist, Moonblitz, you too.
Fuck me.
Oh, that was your current.
Yeah, you... I hope you're ready for, I hope...
I will add one Neo New Earth Denny's coupon.
I hope you're ready for the Neo New Earth newsletter. Moonblitz, because I signed up for it.
As soon as I get the confirmation email, I'm blocking that email.
They also sell you data, so you got quite a few coming your way.
Fuck. Oh.
Please note, unsubscribe. You may unsubscribe to the Neo New Earth newsletter at any time, but unsubscribing is highly illegal.
What? Just get the registration over with.
Okay.
How many pages of EULA is there?
I got this.
I was literally just stalling for time. So you guys head into and down like a flight of stairs into sort of like a pretty darkly lit facility, more reminiscent of the last one you were in.
Oh, good, because this wasn't ominous enough.
This is just the right amount of ominous.
Is there any really right amount of ominous?
I mean, you could definitely have not enough, but you can definitely have too much. So I would say there must be a middle point.
As you kind of as you sort of walk around the corridors and discuss what the right amount of ambiance is for a scary laboratory. You notice three scions being addressed by what appears to be, like, also sort of a scion that most certainly looks like from afar to have like Mirica's hair color, but this one is not wearing like a helmet like the other three. Kind of like, looks like they're having sort of like, almost pretty much like the non-helmeted scion is kind of just berating the others. And after a while, just sort of storms off as the other three just kind of start milling about.
Looks like someone's getting a pay cut.
So, do we have to go through them? Is there any other way around? Psionics are a hassle to deal with.
They're a bit of a pain to deal with. But I will say they sort of shuffle after. After a while, they sort of shuffle after in the direction where what appeared to be the kind of head scion was going. So you've got, like, forward and a corridor to the left and a corridor to the right.
America did the... Oh no, that this part was photoshopped out. Oh no.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Well,
so which way do you...
The last time we were...
So a team vote.
...in the road, I think we went left first and started breaking shit in there.
I vote left.
Alright, lucky left. Everyone be quiet. You too, Scraggly.
Sure thing! Being quiet is the Scraggly special! He yells.
Hey, Moonblitz. Don't address the, puppy.
He shall not be named.
Alright, let's just go. So heading to left, I suppose.
Alright.
Well, now that we have Merica registered, maybe that handprint trick will work more.
Potentially, yeah.
I'm saying this as a character. I'm saying this in character. I don't know, out of character. Yeah.
So, on the left side, you kind of you approach a room with just some sort of like just what appears to be just sort of like, again, sort of people with the like women with the same hair color as Mirica, kind of just like sort of like sitting like motionless, just like in these sort of big chairs with like machinery attached to their heads that's kind of like whirring away.
Hmm.
They make they don't like react in any way when you like enter.
We need to find like machine or I don't know, anything that'll transfer Mirica's, you know, mind back to her body. Is there any machines that look like they would do that in this room? I mean, I don't even know what to look out for.
I'm going to say sort of as you kind of look around, Moonblitz, you do find a terminal that seems to suggest that this station, that like one of the main experiments going on in this station is trying to find a way to kind of replicate minds and like transfer them to another body.
Can I dig further and see if there's any speak of a machine that can specifically do this?
Give me intelligence and computers to do so.
Those are two things I'm actually competent in.
All right,
I'm feeling a little useless this round. I hope I don't fuck up.
Get ready for the Joker.
Two successes, oh thank God.
Maybe next time.
What? Why are you guys upset that I'm not Jokering? Fuck you guys.
It's funny when you Joker.
It is.
I don't want to feel useless. I'm feeling
You're
pretty
not
useless. This session hasn't been the best for me, so two successes, TM.
You dig a little bit further into kind of the sort of nitty gritty of the whole thing, and just kind of have to spoof some login credentials here and there. And you do sort of discover through the various logs that while they've had very little luck replicating brains, they do think they have sort of a tentative grasp on these machines' ability to, like, transfer a brain already.
Are the machines they're talking about this thing in the room, or is it mentioning a different place?
It doesn't clarify.
Fuck, that's what I was looking for.
There is an open seat in one of the chairs, though.
Should we put Merica's body in there? Or what if they all open their eyes at once? Because that's going to really creep me out. I'm not going to lie, fellas.
I got my gun at the ready.
All right. If
Scraggly's got his bag of tricks.
America, are you okay with this? This might be the machine. We're not sure. All right. Moonblitz carefully puts Mirica's unconscious body into the open chair.
Should we be putting the unconscious body or the conscious body in
there? That's a good... Moonblitz is like halfway like, that's a good question. What if we gently take out one of the other ones, and then Cat Mirica sits in that one?
That doesn't sound like a great idea.
No, I don't know. I don't hear anything better being thought of.
Unless we have some space chloroform to work with.
Some sploriform?
Well, you know, the Mirica-esque women in the chairs do seem to be, like, completely catatonic. But you're not sure if that's just because the Scions seem generally pretty docile, or if it's directly being caused by this machine.
So what should we do? Should we put Mirica's real body in there, or should Cat Mirica sit in it?
I feel like Cat Mirica.
Alright. Mirica? Look, if something happens, we'll never forget you. Anyway... And then Moonblitz swings around and just presses whatever button on the terminal activates the thing.
Okay. Well.
Wait. So... Is there like labels? Hold on. Is there like labels for like the different chairs?
There. I'm glad you asked because there are labels.
Okay.
It's 1, 2, 3, and then the one Cat Mirica is sitting into is 4.
Press 4.
And so, Mirica, as you kind of settle into the chair, sort of like a very kind of thin, robotic sort of like tentacles almost, kind of burrow their way into your head. And before long, your vision kind of like fades as you're just sort of like sedated, like mechanically sedated.
Oh god, did we kill Mirica?
And now,
asking that in character. Because he has no idea.
Cat Mirica is currently inside of the. Cat Mirica is currently in chair 4, like complete, like catatonic, like the rest of the other Scions.
Catatonic? And that's the DM adding 5 more goons for the next boss fight.
And so as you, so you kind of go back to the terminal and you kind of see like, it's basically just prompting you, which body you want to transfer which brain into.
Okay.
But we have Mirica's actual body, but we need to put that, could we take out Cat Mirica and put in her real body? Or do they both have to be in a chair at the same time for the transfer to work?
It would appear that both bodies need to be hooked up to this machine for there to be a possibility of transfer.
And there's only 4 chairs, I assume.
Yes.
Okay. All right, guys. So here's the deal. We need to get one of these out of here. That's not Cat Mirica's body, and put in Mirica's real body.
The plan is simple.
Can we safely eject? Can we like press like the safely eject button without, you know?
That's a question.
I'm asking out of character, is there a safely eject for the other bodies? Kind of like the USB thing for Windows.
There is an option. There's a grayed out option for it. That when you kind of hover over, it says, disengagement not available during lockdown scenarios.
Oh, fuck me. Did we try and hack it? Although if we fail at hacking...
It's always by force.
Yeah, but if we do either and we do bad at it, then we could possibly lose Mirica forever. So who's got the best hacking? I have 2 computers and 3 intelligence.
I've got
full intelligence, 2 computers.
I am computers.
He is.
Then the Fist, computer. can you try to do the way without smashing?
Yes.
He's like visibly shaking as he tries to pick the not brute force action.
Try and turn off the protocol for lockdown, whatever.
Intel computers, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you, God Almighty.
Jesus.
This is what you're looking for.
For 4 successes, Fist, you're like, fine. And you just kind of like type away really quickly at the computer and kind of like almost immediately set it to not, and sort of like immediately override the sort of lockdown protocols on it. You're like, I don't know why you guys keep wanting to do this. It's so boring whenever things are solved this way.
Just punch a hole in it.
So is that option available to safely eject device?
It does. It is available. It is currently available.
All right. Let's take out number 3 just because it's the closest.
All right.
Boop.
Number 3 just kind of has all the kind of machinery sort of removed from its brain. And it just sort of gasps awake and it's just kind of like... And it sort of looks around and just is like very sort of confused. It just looks around with this sort of like confused expression.
Hello?
Hey, stay calm.
Do you here speak?
It's just like puts a finger up as if it's saying shh.
We're not here to hurt you.
I am Empire Scion, number... What is my registration number? Do you recall?
Probably like 3.
Very well. I am Empire Scion, designation number 3. Are you commanders?
Yeah, we command you to just do nothing. Stay.
We need to borrow your seat, though. We're trying to help another Scion get back into her normal body. Could we borrow your chair?
I don't understand. Non-personnel should not be in here.
We're commanders.
You want to give me a presence lying really quick?
Here's the thing. I still have that electronic signal that says I'm Empire. Does that give me any advantage?
It allows you to flip.
Oh, good. That's 4 cards. I'm going to use a drive. That's like 1.
It wearily gets up from the chair and kind of leaves the room.
Thank you, number 3.
It doesn't say anything as it kind of walks away.
All right, let's put America, turn this thing on and get the fuck out of here.
Quiet.
So we put America's body, and then is there an option for transfer from 4 to 3?
Yes, there is.
Beep boop. I press the buttons.
The machine kind of the machine sort of hums to life, and just kind of after a while of sort of just like. It's sort of just glowing a little bit, looking very kind of creepy and ominous. And Mirica, your consciousness kind of like shoots to life suddenly. And you kind of like just sort of look down at your now human hands. Mirica is no longer a Ketonian.
Mirica?
Hey, welcome back, Mirica. Good?
You got no sudden urges to wield a sword, right?
Or, cough up a hairball.
More than usual, at least.
What should we do with this Cotonian body? I feel kind of bad.
Hold on.
Okay. Sorry.
Mirica, you have no more urges to wield a sword, but as you kind of look at the sword that you've been using these like past couple of days, and you really do sort of feel an almost you kind of whatever remnants of Cotonian are still in your mind, kind of have the you kind of feel this like weird kinship with it that you kind of understand. I'm gonna say, with your Cotonian sword, Mirica, if you're controlling it with telekinesis, you can use telekinesis instead of melee to attack with it, and you still get the plus one.
So kind of like Kenshi from Mortal Kombat.
Kinda.
That's how I imagine. I like him. He uses a sword, but he uses it telekinesis-wise.
That's neat.
Basically, Mirica can telekinetically wield a Cotonian sword the way someone would. Yeah.
Yeah, he's one of my favorite
characters.
Shut up. Anyway. So I kind of feel bad. Should we take this Cotonian body? I'm asking in character. I don't know. I mean, yeah, they were dicks, but do we just leave it here? I don't know.
Which one was that? Was that the one that was like...
That was two swords.
That was two swords, yeah.
So as you kind of posit this question to the group, you hear a voice that Mirica, you recognize... That you hear a voice that you recognize Mirica kind of say, "You will be leaving everything in this room. Thank you very much." As you guys look and see a scion that appears to be that now that you can see her up close, this helmetless scion, wearing a very nice looking sort of like sort of black red and kind of gold streaked robe, looks Empire to be colors. Like an older version of Mirica. And Mirica, you immediately recognize this person as your older sister, Zirica.
Oh, shit.
I couldn't think of a name. It's way off.
Damn.
I knew I sensed you enter this ship, Mirica. But I never thought you would be so stupid to come here immediately.
The stupid part lies a bit elsewhere.
Yeah. You never sense how stupid we were, right, guys? Wait.
Much has changed since you ran away from home, Mirica. And now so much more will once you... Now so much more will once you're back. As soon as I get Mother's pendant back. Waiting to see if Jibu was going to respond, but it doesn't seem like it.
Oh.
Just give a second.
It's pretty snazzy looking.
I really like the concept of a mute saying, "Not if I have anything to say about it."
Nah, I just got it.
Very well. So, as that happens, so she kind of readies a shield around her, and Scion number three also kind of appears from behind her.
Hey, Billy.
And I knew you weren't commanders. Commander Zirica, surely you're pleased with me helping She's kind of like struggling to kind of like get any work out. And Zirika just kind of goes, yes, yes, I'll be happy once this is over and done with. As you guys enter combat.
Mirka, your whole family is weird.
This is the only one that Mirka is like directly related to.
I know, I was making a joke.
So wait, she's human?
Who?
Zirika.
Zirika's human too, I suppose.
Yeah, she's...
Okay.
All the Scions are basically, like, apparently sort of, like, genetically altered humans.
Okay. Gotcha.
Alright, then do you guys want to make this damage non-lethal then?
Yeah.
Just saying it before that. Moderately sized holes on this one.
Yeah, but not lethal. I'm just saying we should get that out there before the fight starts.
Yeah.
So whose turn is it, Dingle?
Hold on. I'm formulating things. So, Zirika sort of starts off. She kind of holds a hands up and sort of says, you always had our mother's telepathy, but no one can best me in telekinesis. And as she says that, she kind of like breaks, she kind of like forcibly rips the other two Scions out of the machine. And sort of adds them to the, sort of adds and sort of is adding them to the fight. And now it's Moonblitz's turn.
Moonblitz, the shield and sword both kind of like flash up. And Moonblitz says, if you're going to try and get to our friend, you have to get through us first. And Moonblitz is going to like jump forward towards Zirika.
Give me a slash. Agility and melee.
Three successes.
Money where your mouth is.
Oh yeah. Okay. Moving forward. Moving forward. You guys need to flip three less cards on actions. While the three Scions are up.
Sorry.
Dumb.
But for this one, I'm not gonna say anything about it. As you kind of like rush forward. We'll say the Scions are still kind of dazed.
Yeah.
And you kind of rush forward and sort of stab your sword into an incredibly dense energy barrier that seems to sort of absorb the impact, but you do sort of collide with it, but it holds.
Damn.
And, Fist, could you flip a card?
Yeah, sure. My last card.
So, who's who on this? The cards was just still...
Okay. Hold on.
Oh, it's Scraggly, I guess.
Oh yeah, Scraggly's still here. Is Scraggly in the fight?
Yeah, sure.
Fuck yeah.
Hope we don't have to pay Scraggly for his,
Hey, just don't mention it.
Yeah, I'm saying this out of character. I hope we don't have to pay for him helping us in fights.
We got plenty of spooks.
Yeah, but if we're able to save money, that's better.
And... Oh, actually, you know what? I'm gonna move you guys up a little bit. Because two of the Scions are actually behind you.
Yes.
Oh, that's right.
So, three is going to go first. And, seeing the...
Yeah, they're that one there.
Yeah. Alright, so, three, seeing your attack on Zirika Moonblitz, attempts to restrain you, but instead her, telekinesis just kind of, like, sort of fizzles out, and it's just kind of, like, it seems very kind of hard for her to do anything.
Is she Joker?
Yeah. And Zirika goes, these scions, worthless without their helmets. But you and me are different, aren't we, Mirika? And the other scions are gonna... The other scions are going to also gonna try and attack the party. Okay, so, Pikachu, you've got 2 damage incoming, and, so does Fist. As the scions in the back kind of, like, just sort of, like, groggily kind of ready their hands and, like,
Wait, doesn't dodge reset between fights, guys?
It does.
Yeah.
I'm just saying that so... I don't know.
Alright, it's now gonna be Fist's turn.
Alright.
I want to remind Fist that...
Yes.
Your rockets, as of now, are actually back online. Because combat has passed since you last used them.
Hell yeah.
Okay.
Also, I'd like to remind everyone of their old ones, especially ones that need to be activated, like the elusive friendship speech.
Nudge, nudge. Wink, wink.
Yeah, it'll happen. It'll happen one of these days.
I want to run back. So Fist will run back to those tentacle guys, right? Rip them out. And try to, like, grapple one of the scions back here with him.
Wait. So what are you trying to do?
Trying to, like, what's it called? Not... Like a, I forget the word for it, but those things you, like, throw at someone and then their feet just, like, comically tie up.
Oh, what are they called?
Are you trying to hog tie?
No, it's they're not called caltrops. It's the other one.
No, yeah, it starts with a B, I think.
Oh, the baltrops.
Yeah, the baltrops.
No, but there is a word for it.
Yeah.
So I'm just kind of confused what the action is. So you're gonna try and, like, you're trying to tie up one of the scions with, like, the mechanical tendrils from the machine.
Yeah, like. Time up, kind of like.
Oh,
like
wait a minute! You're talking about bolas.
Bolas. Yeah, bolas. That's it.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. Oh. All right, so that's even fucking weirder. That's an even fucking weirder action. You're gonna rip the mechanical tendrils out and use them as bolas to tie something to restrain a scion.
Yes.
Yes.
I'll fuck with it.
Alright, give me, fuck, what the hell is this?
Give me brawn bolas.
Just sideways profile a Fist? Yes.
I guess that's, like... It's definitely melee. I'm trying to determine if that's brawn or agility, though.
That's true.
I'm gonna say it's close enough to brawn, because you have to tear them out.
There. That's what I'm talking about.
The three and a joker.
Three and a joker.
Let's go. You cleanly tear these tentacles out of the machine. But once they're out, they almost seem to have like a mind of their own, and immediately just like tightly just constrict around you.
Right idea. Now this could work. Just give me a sec.
All right. Mirka, that makes it your turn.
So I'm wondering, was the Zirka thing, like, written in just, like, by Dingle? Or was that, like, something that's been planned by Mirka?
So here's the thing. It was written in by me because Jibu, I had this idea for Jibu's backstory, like when he pitched the character initially, and I just basically let him know that. And early on, I just kind of said like, I have an idea, like, but I don't want to like not let you write a backstory. But Jibu said he was fine with mine, so gotcha. I told him that his only memories before being captured was that he was from a village in like on like a planet that he can't remember where everyone had the same hair as him. And I got to writing.
Sweet.
Damn.
I forgot if I need to be checking the Discord more carefully to see what Jibu is typing. Alright, anyone in particular?
That's a pretty sweet action.
Alright.
That it is.
Give me a wit and telekinesis plus one. Or actually, wait a minute, hold on. How does that tie together with the whole... I'm gonna say any scion other than Zirika herself only has minus two on an action. To make that minus one overall on a wit telekinesis. Oh, that is true. It's that. So it's actually just straight wit telekinesis.
What's the pendant again?
Mirka's we now know very sort of plot heavy pendant gives her plus one telekinesis.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
God damn it. I hate it because it's so perfect.
That's great. So, Mirka, you kind of you grab the sword from the hands of the now mindless Ketonian that is like sort of sitting in the chair, and you toss it up into the air, and to outside observers it almost looks like with a mind of its own it just sort of like goes and just like lodges itself like right in the shoulders of one of the scions that just kind of lets out like a that just kind of lets out kind of like a sharp like gasp.
I say it.
And that's to Pikachu now.
Okay. So Fist is currently like suspended by like an arm of the machine. I'm gonna.
Well, not so much suspended. Not so much suspended. There's kind of just like what appears to be kind of just like thin, but apparently like pretty strong, like mechanical tendrils, just kind of like wiggling around and constricting him.
Okay, I'm gonna take an energy blast at like the, like not at him, but like at a bit away that would like free him.
All right, give me an agility and fireworks for that. Plus one. No interference on the action, but you're not targeting an enemy, or at least not an enemy that's being shielded.
Do I get a plus one for firearms? For the gun?
Yes, you do. You do get a plus one from your gun.
A two?
Yeah, you sort of toast those things off, and with almost like a weird, like, mechanical, like, like almost like a hissing, like as if they were alive, they kind of fall off a fist. And it is now going to be Zirika's turn. So, Mirica, you suddenly find you're kind of like watching your sword kind of bury it. So you're still sort of watching your sword kind of like bury itself into the scion, and you start to pull it out. But then it kind of stops almost in like midair and kind of falls to the ground. As you suddenly find yourself sort of stuck inside of a bubble of energy that's like so dense, you actually like can't telekinetically affect things from the that are outside of it. And Moonblitz, that makes it your turn.
Moonblitz, what is this, another force field in front of her?
You can, in a sense, you've basically been. You're kind of in like the types of bubble shields you would normally make around someone, but it's double sided.
You cut out.
Mirica, you're basically in a bubble shield, but it's double-sided.
You cut out for me, Ding. What were you explaining?
Did I cut out for everybody?
No.
I heard you. I don't think you said anything to the Cynical in the first place.
Yeah, no, it was just...
Oh, I was asking what these blue things were.
Oh.
That's just the energy barrier.
I think someone put that there for flavor.
Yeah, that's just to symbolize that there's like an energy barrier around Zirika.
Umblitz is gonna try and break through it again.
All right, give me a brawn and melee plus one.
Okay.
Gonna be right back, super quick.
All right.
Wait, don't I have to minus cards?
Oh, that is true. So it's actually minus two.
Okay, I didn't want to accidentally cheat again.
It's actually brawn melee minus two.
I forgot about that. Oof. You should drag that Joker back.
Trying, okay.
That's how she goes.
So... you kind of you stab your energy sword forward, and you notice there's like a bit more give as Zirika lets it sort of like lets a hole open up in the center of it, just enough for you to put your arm through, get the sword like semi close to her, and she then slams it shut around your arm. And you're kind of like in an arm lock, like with the barrier. So basically, your sword arm is trapped, kind of like by the barrier around it.
Oh, I've got a funny idea for this then.
And with that, the scions are gonna make a move.
Unbuck.
Right. Sword arm stuck into the force field. Like, she opened it and then closed it, and now my arm is stuck in there.
Yeah, okay. she opened up for a second, then sort of closed it around, like, Moonblitz's, like, elbow to get his arm stuck.
Did Fist roll a Joker? Or was that last turn?
That was Moonblitz.
I rolled it.
Oh.
Joker.
It's in a Fist's deck.
That was last turn's Joker.
Okay.
Oh, shit. See, I rolled a Joker, too.
Gotcha.
Okay. The scions are gonna go. Three has gotten her, three has apparently gotten her bearings a little bit more. And you've got two damage incoming, Moonblitz.
Do I still get to use that interference?
Oh, that's right. Make it one.
I only lose one dodge.
And then the ones from behind also have to go.
I'm glad I got something to help with defense. Thank you for that, Ding.
You're welcome, but that was totally on accident that I wrote that. I had someone with like the defender trait written into it, and I really hadn't thought of like, oh, how does that actually like play out like in universe that like someone can shield allies?
Yeah.
And,
it worked out nicely.
Enter personal energy shield. Alright, Fist and Pikachu both have another point of damage coming their way.
Oh, I can edit this without going into the actual thing now.
Huh. Very cool.
Yeah.
Wait, what?
You can just click on it instead of...
Oh, that's okay. Really helpful.
Yeah.
You learn something new every day.
Alright, Fist. You're up.
Alright. So which... Chibu attacked one of the scions in the back, right?
Yeah, one of the back scions is, like, clutching what looks to be a pretty grievous wound right now.
I guess for flavor, he's just gonna go grab one of those helmets and just like slam it onto them, to do more of a physically based attack than to actually use the helmet for what it's meant to do.
Okay, give me brawn melee. On which one is this for?
Whichever the damage one is.
Okay, cool.
No jokers.
Yeah, that is enough. You just sort of cave this scion's skull in.
Oh.
By like, you kind of like flip the helmet upside down and just sort of bash it into the top of its head.
Sweet.
gruesome, Jesus.
And with that, I get 2 more dodge.
That is true.
Which I will remember this time instead of last time when I used the panel.
So which one was knocked out?
Let's call it this one.
Just moving it just so it's we know what's on the field.
Yeah. And now it's time for Scraggly, who, since he didn't go last turn, I'm gonna say he was he's now done he's now done funneling just random salvage into his bag.
And some of it, yeah.
As a dead Scion's body kind of falls next to him, he kind of realizes, like, I'm kind of in trouble. Hey, Scraggly, too! Why don't you go ahead and shoot the... Fellas, which ones do I shoot? There's a lot of purple-haired ones.
The ones that aren't us.
Don't shoot the one dressed in green.
Okay, Scraggly 2, you heard him. Oh, I forgot I need to take a... Scraggly 2 kind of bursts to light and kind of has like... with a very small machine gun arm, kind of starts to fire like bullets at one of the Scions, who is able to deflect most of them, but some of them get through and kind of like whiz past, and kind of just sort of like graze her like face and clothes. That'll be right here. Since Scraggly doesn't actually fight, just say the red piece is gonna be where Scraggly 2 is. And now with Scraggly 2 activated, Scraggly goes back to just... Really, he's just picking up random things. You see him ball up a spider web and throw that in? There's really no rhyme or reason to it.
If it can be put in, it will.
Alright, Mirica, you are up, and you are currently, You're trapped inside the anti-Mirica bubble. I'm gonna say you can still like you can sort of roll yourself around in it, but anything that's like outside of the bubble like apparently seemingly can't be manipulated. I'm gonna say until that bubble's off of you, it's gonna be pretty hard to, without also getting whoever you're healed trapped inside that bubble with you.
Damn, this is a banger song.
Yeah, I'm gonna say with, give me intelligence and telepathy to try and, like, destabilize it. Or intelligence and telepathy, or, well, I know, you know what, I said telepathy, I can't take it back now. I feel like there's probably more telekinesis, but I can't take it back. boy, a joker.
I feel like we... Actually, I'm not going to complain because the anti-joker was used to help us heal, but we always end up using the anti-joker early on for something that's important, but then, like, another important thing comes up. Know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's true.
Mirka, you attempt to try and kind of, like, destabilize the bubble, but Zirika almost immediately notices you doing that, and just sort of, and you take one damage as it kind of, like, compresses in a little bit around you and kind of, like, is, like, sort of, like, crushing you just a bit.
What a cold-hearted bitch.
You just stay put, sister. We'll deal with our business afterwards.
Is it dodgeable?
That is not dodgeable.
I don't see how you'd be able to dodge that.
You
totally dodge the bubble surrounding me.
And that makes it Pikachu's turn.
Hang in there, Mirka.
I wanna organize this a little bit more. I don't want people getting the idea that Zirika is protecting anyone but herself.
That's
right,
totally
now.
The idea I had. I'm still gonna attack her energy force field with a blast.
Alright. Give me a brawn and... Or no, firearms. That's right. You use firearms
is it
to
plus
use
or
gun.
Minus anything? I get plus one from firearms, but there's minus something.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be... It's only minus two now, because you've taken out one Scion.
Okay... It's a Warner.
Yep. You get a glancing blow on the barrier. Eh. The barrier holds. And with that, it's going to be Zirika's turn again. Oh, hold on. Oh, damn. Oh, wait a minute. How many cards was that? Oh, why did I flip so few? Okay. So, Moonblitz, with your arm so close, I'm gonna say, kind of take one undodgeable damage as your arm is kind of like very painfully forced out of the bubble shield.
Oh, I had an idea. If it was going to stay in there, man.
She almost flipped no successes. She got very close on 8 flips to getting no successes.
Man, I had a cool idea. I was kind of hoping my arm would still be in there. I was going to turn the arm into the crossbow and just shoot at point blank range.
Does it work like that? Can both arms be... I thought one arm was the crossbow and one was the sword.
Oh, I thought he shared an arm for both the crossbow and the sword, and the other one was used for the shield. That way he could have the shield up while he was doing the crossbow.
Yeah, that makes more sense. Well, in another life, maybe. She didn't flip that like Ace of Clubs. It's still your turn, though. So now you have an opportunity to do something else cool.
That's the only cool idea I had, though.
Well, you know what? When God closes the door, he opens a window, Cynical.
Okay, I have kind of a reckless idea. Moonblitz is going to do a backflip.
That's crazy.
Moonblitz is going to do a backflip and in midair transform into his jet mode and fly straight at the bubble with the specifically the wing that can use the energy shield or the energy sword.
All right.
And try and break through it with both using like velocity.
I mean, that's definitely agility and piloting.
Minus two.
Yes, minus two.
Okay, so that's one, two, three.
You've got two layers of thin energy bubble too that you're flying through. It's almost like molasses at this point.
I'm going to use
a driver Reno.
Yeah, driver Reno. Actually, wait. I'll use a hero point. I haven't used a hero point yet.
Okay.
I'll use a drive. So that's one success.
Lure it.
So two successes.
All right. At two successes. Yeah, you just kind of like energy. You sort of like have sort of like a flyby with the energy sword wing, and kind of just sort of bash the shield, which still holds but is looking a little bit cracked here and there.
I'm trying.
You are trying. Say what you will. But you really do be trying.
Okay, how are you? Yeah, I...
Alright, that makes it... Oh, that's the Scions now.
Okay, October 21st.
Okay.
21st. 1995.
So whose turn is it?
It's the Scions. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Moonblitz, you've got two damage incoming. And Pikachu, you've got three.
Is this dodgeable?
Yes, both of these damages are
so
theoretically dodgeable.
Theoretically.
So I've got Pikachu. Three damage.
You've got three incoming.
That's rough.
Yeah, these Scions, they do be flipping. That one got a crit, which is why that was so high. And now it's Fist's turn.
Yeah, it is.
Chibi,
please. Probably.
Is there any wall panels?
Surprisingly, this is not, it's surprisingly panel-less.
Wow.
Fuck. At least they seem to go in They must have had a problem with people tearing out the panels and using them for combat before. Which is the only conceivable reason why you wouldn't have large panels composing all the walls in space, I think.
Makes sense. I guess I'll just go for a straightforward on this other side. Simple punch. Are these ones minus two as well?
These ones are minus one now.
Just realized I forgot about that. Oops.
Ooh!
Good old three success.
Bada bing, bada boom.
With a crit, you are able to pretty easily just sort of like You just kind of, like, cut through the now kind of, like, less dense energy barrier and just send, like, a punch just, like, right into the chest of this scion. And it kind of, like, staggers back for a moment and then sort of, like, falls to its knees unconscious.
So he's out of commission now.
That one is out of there.
Oh. Well.
Damn, okay. So, Scraggly 2, from out of nowhere, just sort of fires a small rocket at the Zirika's barrier, which continues to hold, but now has, like, much sort of deeper cracks sort of running along it.
Damn, Scraggly. You're packing that heat.
You know it, friend!
Is that the Scraggly special?
What? I didn't do that!
Never mind.
Scraggly too special.
A pre-recorded voice line reads off, "Packing the heat is the Scraggly 2 special." And with that, it is Mirica's turn again. Or wait a minute, hold on. What barrier did I say it was attacking?
Zirika's. I mean, isn't that the only barrier?
No, I wanted it to free Mirica so she could do something this turn.
Oh, right.
All right, Mirica, you're freed.
Okay.
Alright, that's intelligence and bio. And you remember, you're back in your own body. You have full bio again.
Nice.
Alright, that's a crisp 2 right off the bat.
Yo, I'll take it.
Okay. That is 6 extra health for Pikachu as Groovy fucking suffers a heart attack.
Quick, do the unfuck.
Someone type unfuck.
I've been doing it. Lads, it's not working.
Jibu,
what are you
doing?
Jibu, no!
I got this.
I
got this.
I got this.
Alright. I'm fully invigorated. I'm gonna do another energy blast at the surrounding barrier around Zirika.
Alright. Hit him with it.
Is it firearms?
Yeah, brawn firearms.
I think it's -1 overall. Fuck.
Fuck. Pikachu. The energy blast gets very close to the barrier, but Zirika kind of holds off a hand and is just sort of like. And it's just sort of, sends to stop it in midair. And just sort of looks, and goes, "Your kind have always been so aggravating." Wow, this is really fucking up. PQ, you've got 3 damage incoming as your own energy blast is kind of like accelerated very quick back towards you.
God, they got healed.
It's a good thing you got healed.
Because I fixed it.
The unfucks got through.
Finally.
I like how that's probably going to be our new, like, spam if Groovy fucks up in the future.
That's pretty good.
Alright, Zirika kind of, like, takes stock of her sort of surroundings. And just like, for a moment, just kind of, like... Well... This is becoming fairly tiresome. And she kind of, clasps her hands together and, seems to ready something pretty powerful. And she kind of, like, clasps her hands together and then sort of pushes them forward. And everyone, including her own ally, is going to take 1 damage.
Dodgeable?
It is dodgeable, yes.
Okay.
Good thing I have 0 dodge. Currently.
All right, Moonblitz, that makes it your turn.
Sorry, I was saying a bite out of my burger.
Oh, burger.
My gamer fuel.
Oh, big burger.
Burger. Moonblitz is going to... I don't know, he's just trying to break through the barrier. He's gonna start, like, swinging wildly at the, he got pushed back, and then he's going to thrust himself forward with his jet boosters and swing wildly at the, force field.
Is he still right. In flame form?
No, he transformed back into robot form.
Okay.
Okay.
So what is that?
That's Brawn melee.
Oh, Brawn, okay.
It would normally be +1, but there's still a Scion up.
Yeah.
2 successes.
Not bad.
The barrier holds, but the cracks are deepening.
How fucking... God damn it.
That's number 3's turn.
So who's going next?
Yes, that is number 3's turn. What are you doing?
See if clicking on the number next to it did anything. It doesn't.
Stop trying to cheat, Zell.
Yeah.
Oh. This is actually a... Thank you, Joker. This is a perfect way to introduce this. Number 3 kind of sort of like readies an attack and kind of like deciding on who to aim. when suddenly a plasma-bladed katana, like, tears through her midsection. As the commander kind of, like, arrives on the scene. And is kind of just like... Y'all look like you're having fun,
Mirka. Barely the never commander.
These Empire troops are just too much fun to run through. I couldn't resist. Speaking of which, I didn't realize we were having a family reunion.
Something like that.
So, with that, it's gonna be, it's now Mirika's turn. Oh, damn. Okay. Is that the last of the medkit charges? Wait, no, it's not. You haven't used them yet. Since you got the one at the base. Oh, it is. It is. Okay. So yeah, intelligence bio.
So what's the situation now with Zirka?
Zirka's got like a sort of like very beat up barrier present.
All right.
How strong is your barrier?
It's very strong. And that was it's a pain in my ass. Pikachu, heal 4.
It's a shitload of fuck is what it is.
What were they thinking?
Alright, you know the drill. Energy blast time.
Alright.
Energy gun go brrr. Is it still minus one?
No, all the scions are gone now.
Okay. I think I got another one after this.
I believe so, yeah.
3 plus... Just 3.
Alright. That you sort of get a collision kind of right into the crack, and the thing is looking like pretty damn near to like shattering.
It's still there.
God,
that's
fucking
so
damn it.
Mario.
Can I pull back the curtain on why this barrier is so strong?
Please.
I used a trick from the book where boss's health is determined by a number times party members.
Are you counting the NPC party members?
I mean, they were attacking, so...
Yes.
Oh. Damn you, Scraggly, he made this harder.
He also got some rockets off, so...
Yeah, it is true. I think it's...
He's also gotten, like, a combined, like, 6 successes over the course of, like, 2 turns.
Yeah.
So we can chill on Scraggly.
I won't hear any Scraggly slander right now.
Zirka takes a moment to sort of take stock of her kind of like cracked barrier and dead scions. And just goes... These lower level scions really make for useless allies. But, you resistance seem to have some strong ones among your ranks. And, as she says that, she kind of holds a hand out towards the commander. And her body kind of, like, almost sort of, like, seizes up for a moment. Before letting loose a very fast attack at a Pikachu.
Well,
and it's at, wait, that's the one damage. Heal. That's one damage incoming. Okay. As it ends up just kind of grazing you. The commander, what the? Hey, she's like trying to choke out, kind of like, That's quite all right. That's quite all right, Meat Shield. You don't need to be talking right now. It seems that Zirika is like, sort of like through telekinesis, kind of like puppeteering the commander's body. As it is, it's now gonna go to Moonblitz.
Moonblitz.
Moonblitz is gonna try and do a whirlwind spinning attack at the force field.
All right. I know you're trying to bait the agility melee, do you?
But why not? I'm flavoring it correctly.
Agility melee.
Thank you.
Plus one. There's no more scions.
Off!
The current
Joker. No, that's
Joker.
Fine. No, that's fine. This works, actually.
This is the
this
second
works.
Time I've Joker when doing a spinning attack, I think.
This actually works very perfectly.
Okay, just don't be too mean.
I knew exactly what to do in case something like this happened.
Don't be too mean, please. I'm trying.
Your attack collides with the barrier and finally shatters it. But,
oh, I see.
Hmm?
I think I see where this is going.
Seeing kind of the course of the battle, Zirika is just sort of like, I suppose we'll have to continue this another time, Amirika. As she kind of like telekineses herself forward onto the commander's back, and the commander slashes like a large hole in the roof of this area, and jumps through it, taking Zirika with her. It seems that Zirika is trying to use the commander's physical ability to make a getaway.
Does that lead outside, or...?
It leads to, like, the floor above.
How big is the hole?
It's big enough for, like, a human to jump through.
I'm human-sized. Technically.
You are, technically.
Can I jump through the hole?
Sure. You guys are out of combat now, by the way.
Can I give chase to them?
Yeah, give me a... I'm assuming you want to...
Are they doing anything, like, specific? Are they running down a hall? What are they doing?
The commander is Naruto running down the hall.
Moonblitz is gonna try and turn into a plane to catch up with them.
Yeah, alright. Agility and piloting.
Okay. So 8.
Fist will tag along with the rockets.
Alright, cool. Jesus.
Come on!
It's agility and athletics for
really?
Me.
Man, right, I've been so useless this fucking session.
Brawn athletics.
Man.
Yeah, no.
Wait. You guys kind of just like...
I had 2 successes, technically.
You guys just sort of like stumble around each other and are kind of like getting in each other's way. As you see Zirika kind of force the commander's like body telekinetically into a escape pod and sort of jump in along with her, and it kind of blasts off.
All right, that's it. Is there an open space where the escape pod was now?
There is.
Boomblitz is going to jump through that. And now he has more room outside, and he's going to follow the escape pod. He's really... Okay. He doesn't want to lose someone important in the resistance.
All right. Then more agility piloting.
I feel like that's in character.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm gonna... I don't have any drive left. Oh, I do have a hero point?
Yeah, I'm gonna use a hero point. You still have a hero point.
That didn't do much. Two successes.
You don't quite overtake them, but you're keeping enough of a pace to kind of follow them. To everyone else, however... You are now kind of, you're kind of like, everyone else is still sort of like in the ship. I'm going to say you guys are outside of the secret area now.
Yeah.
But, you're going to need to, but like, as you kind of step out, Pikachu and Mirica, you two as, biologicals, notice that the air is getting very thin in here. There seems to, the commander's rampage seems to have caused enough structural damage to the ship that the life support can't really pump in enough oxygen to counteract what's escaping. So, you guys are gonna need to run to the ship, like, very quickly with an, agility athletics.
Alright.
Scraggly coming along?
I mean, he kind of doesn't have a choice.
Wait, Fist, did you need to flip that? You're a robot.
Oh.
Well, no, he still had to flip to run.
Yeah. Okay.
That is true.
Hero point, then.
I'm gonna drive.
Good hero point.
Good hero point. Alright, so you guys kind of, so you all kind of, like, run to the loading bay, where you can see that the ship has kind of, like, pulled up, and, Gary is presumably at the wheel, and you see Chauncey just kind of, like, going, like, hey guys, maybe get in here! I don't know, maybe if you wanted to die on a spaceship, it's cool. So, Pikachu, you kind of make it, Chauncey grabs onto the gun arm and sort of pulls you in. But, Pikachu, Mirica, and, Fist, you guys don't quite stick the landing, and are kind of, like, floating now nearby the ship. You guys need to somehow get on, or you're gonna start taking damage from, inhaling space air.
Can I try and find the space rope?
There's no more space rope.
Fuck.
Gary.
Oh wait, Pikachu, you're trying to find the space rope?
Yeah.
Wait, you know who has space rope?
Scraggly!
Oh my god. Hey, Scraggly, you got any, space rope?
I might.
We'll pay you back later.
It's
gonna be one hell of a Scraggly bill. We're gonna go back to being broke as fuck.
Ooh. Okay, that was a good flip from Scraggly. Both of you, I want straight agility from to grab the rope that Scraggly is throwing to you.
If you don't get it, you literally die. Okay.
That's enough with Scraggly's two successes on throwing it. You two sort of grab on, and Pikachu, you, Scraggly, and Chauncey all kind of just pull them in. as Gary kind of, and once the door is shut, Gary kind of calls out over like the ship's intercom, kind of like, I see Moonblitz kind of going that way. We're going to try and make it up to him.
That's a good plan.
And so Moonblitz, you are currently tailing behind the escape pod with that has Zirika and the commander inside of it.
Yeah.
What are you going to do with it?
Moonblitz is going, I don't know. Is there any way he can like boost or should? He doesn't really have anything other than his regular thrusters, I don't think.
Yeah, I don't think so, yeah.
He can take out his, he can have his gun, like, you know, appear from like on the belly of the ship for him and shoot at it.
All right.
So that's how he's done like air combat before. So what is that?
Actually, make that intelligence and firearms.
Okay, good thing my intelligence is the same as my agility.
Using ship weapons is like intelligence. Because you gotta activate all kinds of machineries.
Two successes. Moonblitz is like really pissed off and motivated, I guess.
You blow a sizable hole in the side of the escape pod. And
oh, he's normal size, by the way, now. Like, not like human size, he's now his regular size. I'm just making sure that in case he can get the commander, he can have her safe in the cockpit.
Well, that's good, because the commander is kind of like jettisoned out. Apparently Zirika decided having you chase after the commander is more trouble than it's worth.
Can Moonblitz like quickly like open the hatch and have the commander and he's not gonna follow Zirika. He was more worried about the commander, so
I was gonna say, yes, you can do that, but if you do, you're going to lose the escape pod.
Well, I think one, that's way cooler. Like, that's way more, you know, plot cooler. And two, he was more worried about the commander than Zirika.
Yeah.
And then catches her, closes his...
Yeah, I'm going to say you just do that because I literally... for you to Joker on this action.
What?
No, I have nothing planned for if you, like, fail to do this, so you just do it with no flips.
Decompresses the cockpit.
Yeah. The commander, like, kind of takes a moment to kind of right herself and just, like, oh! That is actually the most uncomfortable thing I've ever felt.
Commander, I'm glad you're relatively safe. I tried.
She kind of hits the dashboard with her fist and sort of like almost like a fist bump and just kind of like, thanks a bunch, kid.
Should we go after the psionic, or should we meet up, or should we regroup?
The ship pulls up. And the escape pod, you in the inky blackness of space, you can no longer see it.
I guess that sort of answers that.
Gary kind of pulls the ship around where you can just kind of maneuver yourself in.
Moonblitz does shrink himself once the commander is safely out of the driver's seat, and they're both inside the ship.
What? I hit two plays and somehow Groovy interpreted that as Mofo's lives, Granny.
What the fuck does that even mean?
Oh, maybe it searched.
It's playing like a random stream.
Okay.
It just chose a random YouTube video.
And it's in French.
Yo, that's fucking weird.
Well.
So what happens now?
This is it.
Zell, stop it. What the fuck?
Oh my god. So two plays and YouTube plays a random YouTube video.
No, I think it.
I think it's just play.
You can play and then search. Yeah.
I don't. Okay. Well.
Anyway.
I think it just interpreted the link as a search that ended up as that somehow.
So, Gary's just kind of so. Everyone is just kind of on the ship now. And you're just kind of, Gary and Chauncey pretty quickly notice that, Mirica is no longer a cat. And they are, very sort of like, oh, well, I don't know what happened in there, but apparently it was pretty good overall.
We pressed the unvuck button.
Relatively good is the defining term here.
As he kind of looks, as Gary's eyes kind of scans around, he notices the commander and just kind of like stops for a second and just kind of like, Commander?
Gary, why don't you go prep the pilot's bay? I'll be there in a minute.
All right, sure thing.
Low-key, Moonblitz is trying to make sure Gary doesn't get fucked in the ass by a red katana.
Gary's still pretty uncomfortable around the commander after the whole incident on Heath.
Moonblitz is trying to help.
Yeah.
Gave him a good excuse.
So the commander kind of looks around just kind of like, well, I don't know. Wasn't a total bust. We took out an Empire facility, and they're gonna have some. And old Galactimus is gonna have some real explaining to do over at Papillon Prime why a facility like that was still active.
And bet you they're gonna have Tom Jones stuck in their head for at least a week.
What? I'm gonna say the commander was the.
Definitely did not know that.
The commander definitely did not notice that the music.
Moonblitz doesn't give context.
The commander was definitely playing J-pop in her headphones.
She was definitely playing the Revengeance soundtrack. I think.
They were both on the playlist.
Healthy mix.
Well,
in the end, it has to be this way.
Well, I guess it was a job well done overall. At this point, probably just want to head back to the base and figure out what we're going to do next time on RPG.
What does that mean,
Commander?
I don't know. I just kind of said it. What the fuck? Fade to black. All right.
That was a good session.
Nice.
The Miracat arc has concluded.
We got some really bad jokers.
There were quite a few.
There were quite a few rough jokers. Would you guys anti-jokered on that heel? I knew it was gonna mean disaster. Because I had full knowledge of the fight you guys were about to encounter.
Well,
and I'm
if
like,
didn't anti-joker on that heel, that would have been.
I probably wouldn't have killed anyone.
No.
Thanks for telling us now.
I don't want to give you a chance.
probably wouldn't have helped in future situations.
Yeah,
that's fair.
So. Now, I don't want... So, as far as hero points, everyone set them to one.
Okay.
Everyone gets a hero point from me.
We usually all get a hero point.
Yeah. And you guys do so good every time. I don't want you to... I want to give you one on the house.
Yeah.
And speaking of which, I was almost considering you guys, I don't know, because I don't want this to take, I don't want this session portion of it to take like too long, but I've gotten through Pretend Friends enough to where on my re-listen to where I'm on the second season or like the second season of the space campaign, and they started doing something which I think is really cool, which is letting you guys decide two heroes per session. Because it kind of throws more, puts more hero points around, and you guys don't have to, you know, you guys, everyone kind of gets some love in a system like that. So I really like that. That's kind of the point. That's kind of the main point of hero points.
So what? We all get another hero point?
No, you are.
We all get to give one more.
Cynical. Who are your two heroes of?
America, and. I can't really decide between Fist and Pikachu. They're both really good this session. I'll give one to Pikachu. Pikachu is.
Let's go.
All right. Hold on. Let me get that. Let me bring that pin up. So, Jibu and Zegend are now at two hero points. Everyone else is at one. All right, Jibu. Who are your two heroes?
By the way, even though it's illegal, that wouldn't stop a resistance member. Boom Blitz does unsubscribe from the stupid ass newsletter. Fuck the Empire and fuck their newsletter. And fuck their Space Denny's coupons.
And I've still got that Space Denny's coupon in my inventory. So.
Well, you only get in one.
All right, that works for me. Oh, god damn it. I need to open up the pin again.
I like how Tubby responded.
Pretty good.
You get the fuck up, Tubby LMFAO. Jesus, H. All right.
And on to Zegend.
My first one has to go to America for throwing the sword in the air and using telekinesis to launch it, which was a sweet attack. And my other one was for Fist for bringing back the panels, because they're awesome.
They're a great time.
Excuse me.
Yeah, me too.
And then Zell.
For as much as you didn't like them, I'll give them to Cynical and this great Jokers that really set the tone.
Without dying despite his five Jokers.
Let it be known, Moonblitz did. Let it be known for all his belly aching. Moonblitz did become unconscious from one of his Jokers.
That is
never
true.
Mind. He actually okay, cool.
Thanks. You would have said something nice.
I was going to.
Why?
You don't deserve it.
I was gonna say, in spite of your Jokers, Moonblitz never went unconscious.
And,
but then I realized
also...
you literally went unconscious from your first Joker.
Nah, he'll be my
he also
upper.
Did
he
find
count.
A scraggly again. So
I saved the commander. Fuck
yeah,
you. He did.
Yeah,
you did save the commander at the end.
Secondly, probably go.
You know, I feel like this system is just as stressful because you're like you're picking one person to leave out.
I think Pikachu for that clutch spoke at the end.
Remember the spoke.
Never forget the spope.
Never forget.
All right. And as far as anti-jokers, who are we thinking?
Who had it this time?
I did.
It was Zell's anti-joker this session.
Well, I think the king of jokers should get it this time. Let's go cynical. You have the power now.
Okay.
Who merely adopted the Joker?
He was born in it.
I'm Joker's reckoning. You get burnt fast. It's according true. To Tubby.
Damn.
That's how it be on this picture of Earth.
That was all a good right. session, y'all.
Yeah, now I gotta think of what you guys are doing next, now that I don't have this arc to kind of carry my writing.
Well, Ding, there's another arc. I don't know what you have planned, but there's another arc that we're working on.
Gawk, that is true.
I don't know if you want to do that yet, or if you want to do something else first. God fucking damn it!
Actually, you know what? That arc we can probably do pretty soon. I just like. Okay, actually, I do kind of have a basic framework of what I'm gonna do.
If you need any questions, you can hopefully ask me.
I've actually got an idea of where I want to take you guys next. I just need to write in a way that. In universe makes sense for you guys to get there.
Alright.
So, look forward to that.
Oh, but boys, I have some good news. Petra moved in today.
And we've also got Scraggly with us for the time being.
You do, for the time being, for better or worse, have Scraggly.
We got a little.
Wanton scavenger and actual insane person on your ship.
We kind of got our own Planet Express crew on this ship now. Yeah.
It's getting close. It's.
No, there's four and four players now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For the time being.
Petro moved in today.
Nice.
My boy, he's home from the Clown Wars. Also known as Twitter.com.
I'm glad you didn't joker on getting Petro in your town.
Yeah.
And I said this earlier, but I didn't realize I had put a staircase next to the house where he moved in. So literally he also now lives next to the staircase so he can do the Joker dance.
He can finally do his Joker cosplay.
I love him. I love how his room is like the cloud theme.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. And it has Julian's like the fog. Like
yeah.
He has like the fog at the bottom.
That's really neat. It's very unfitting for a clown, but really
I
neat.
Would have thought maybe like a circus thing. I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, there's literally a whole, unless it's not in this game, there's like a whole set of balloon furniture.
It's not in the game, I don't think.
Oh, really? The balloon furniture is just straight up gone.
I believe
didn't
so.
People not like damn, the, damn, furni- written, the specific balloon furniture that you had to get from Only Balloons? I don't think some people liked that.
It's not well, the furniture itself, really. It's more that was the only thing you could get from balloons in the early.
Oh. Yeah,
exactly. Balloons yeah. only dropped either balloon furniture or, I believe, also like the hat came from it as well.
So they changed it back to just furniture just comes from the balloons?
Yeah, they changed it back to how it was in previous games where it would just give you items. Balloons are actually sick in this game.
The only one common. I have so far is the Easter ones.
Yeah, it's the only full set I have that I've, even though I don't really like it, I've been keeping it in my house.
I've been thinking, I made an extra set of Easter balloon, Bunny Day balloons. I'm thinking I'm going to gift them to Petro so he can put them in his house.
Good idea.
That's actually really sick. If you ever get, because I know the balloon hat is in this game. If you ever you need to give it to him. He would look perfect walking around in like a balloon top hat.
I love him.
That's true.
I also still love that he's smug. It's just so weird.
There's like this dialogue where he says, I'm thinking of taking some acting classes soon. I'm like, yes.
All right. I gotta get some food.
Fair enough.
I will see you fellas around.
GG's.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
See ya. Bye.